Let's talk about science now, as it is the National Science Week. One of the highlights for sure is Indigenous Science Experience Community Day in Redfern, which is a free community event. Visitors will be able to learn about Aboriginal astronomy, bush medicine, and also will have the opportunity to try some hands-on activities. We are now joined by Professor Joanne Jamie, who is a co-director of the National Indigenous Science Education Program, and also by William Fraser, a Bunjalung man who has been involved in the National Indigenous Science Experience Program and hosts the Indigenous Science Experience. So hello and welcome to both of you.
Hello.
Hi, Shaka.
Thanks for joining us. So to start, let's talk about, what is the National Science Week?
Oh gosh, National Science Week is the biggest event across the country where you get to have the entire country having the possibility of immersing themselves in science and technology and engineering and mathematics, both face-to-face and online. I believe there's over 1,800 different types of activities for National Science Week.
Mm-hmm. One of the activities is the Indigenous Science Experience Community Day in Redfern. What can we expect?
This is a really special day. So the Community Day, which is on Saturday, August 17, it provides an opportunity for the public who come to Sydney to be immersed in science, technology, and culture. We have a whole host of different presenters of science and technology, including many First Nations presenters, which we're very excited about. And so it's a day to really learn directly from Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander scientists and technologists, and to be very hands-on with a whole host of activities, which I'm very happy to explore further with you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm really curious about that. So what are the hands-on activities?
Oh, there's so many. So you can make your own medicinal plant extracts and test them for their antioxidant properties. You can get to learn all about customarily used seaweeds and their significance in health and in environment. There is an opportunity to learn all about our native plants right from the seed through to how they end up in our bowl through a wonderful organization, Bush to Bowl. We are going to hear all about native bees, get to do wonderful movement science that incorporates culture, get to learn about Indigenous astronomy. We will be looking at plants that have an important connection to culture in that they have natural pigments that can be used to dye textiles. And we will be looking at so many things across physics and chemistry and biology and mathematics and technologies with many presenters. What I'd like to particularly highlight is two of those. So firstly, we will have the wonderful Yagal elders, Auntie Glenda McPhail and Shane McClay. They represent Yagal community who have been a part of the Indigenous Science Experience at Redfern since its start in 2012. So annually we've had Yagal elders involved. They will bring along some of their medicinal plants and bush foods and engage with the public on sharing their knowledge about those. The other group I really particularly want to highlight is actually a number of students, secondary school students, that will be along as part of the National Indigenous Science Education Program. So these students are coming from Wagga Wagga and Northern New South Wales, and they will co-lead a range of the activities that we run so that the public can see these great students being role models and leaders of science and STEM.
So it will be like a very busy day with lots going on.
Absolutely.
And I know that one of the hosts will be Will Fraser, who's also joining us. Hello, Will.
Hello.
You have been hosting these events for a while. Can you tell us what usually is the crowd favorite?
Oh, well, it depends on what age group you're in. I think when I first started going to these events back when I was in high school, it was definitely making slime. I know kids really love making slime, and it seems to have been a favorite for many years now, but now that I'm getting a bit older and a bit more relaxed in some of these events, I personally more enjoy checking out things like the weaving, listening to what elders have to say about customary medicines, and of course the bush tucker as well, because I absolutely love food. So being able to have those different things for everybody and whatever you're interested in, and always connect it back to culture, is what's really important for me. And I think what people love about coming along to this Indigenous science experience each year.
You said about that there is a wide range of age of people who can come. So is there like an age limit? How young or how old can the visitors be?
Absolutely no limit. Each year we see people come along with their newborns having a great time. We have elders, of course, and people in that older age group too coming along, people middle-aged going to some of the great sessions that we have during the day on Indigenous astronomy is always really popular. So honestly, everybody is welcome, and everybody will be able to get something interesting out of the day.
Awesome. What is the aim of these events? Do you hope to inspire more people to become scientists?
Well, that's definitely part of it. I think it's great to have community engagement and communicating about how great science is across the whole of National Science Week and at this event as well. And I think really showing to people that Indigenous Australians are the first scientists, and we have so much cultural knowledge that links in and can be considered just on the same level as Western science, is something that's really important. As Joanne was touching on before, part of the event as well is that this is run by Indigenous student leaders from rural schools in New South Wales and throughout Sydney as well. And it's really important to be able to make sure that those kids have a place in this event, and they're able to get inspired by science and the community engagement and the connection to culture and mentorship and everything else that is involved in this program. So it's more than just what you see on the day. There's a whole education program behind it that's inspiring the next generation of First Nation scientists.
When I was at school, I remember science being the feared subjects usually because they were too
Yes.
difficult.
Yes, science is cool. We have to make sure that people realize that.
And to follow on from Will, yeah, this event is absolutely for everyone who can make it to Sydney. It is such an important event to highlight the significance of the knowledge of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander peoples. And we're very proud that this is an event that really showcases that in a beautiful, respectful way. But particularly having the National Indigenous Science Education Program students co-leading these activities is incredibly important. My favourite is, well, one of my favourites, I like them all, but one of my favourites is actually Renee Cawthorn and her weaving. So she not only gets everyone to sit down and weave, but talks about all the science behind that in terms of the plant fibers being used, in terms of the cultural significance. And it's such a beautiful, immersive session. And I just wanted to highlight the significance of this in that Renee was involved in our education program, was a former Macquarie University student, and she's now designing our first fully Indigenous science subject for our university students. So she's sharing her knowledge and that of her elders to get all of our university students really respecting Indigenous knowledge systems, which is really fantastic as well. So she's one of my favourites with this, but we have such a diverse, inclusive range of activities that everyone will find something of interest. I must say, we're not actually doing that much slime because we have so many other wonderful things that we want to show the public. They can do slime anywhere else, but here to be able to meet these wonderful elders, meet these other scientists and technologists, and get hands-on involved in their cultural learnings is really important.
And well, which one are you looking forward to?
Oh, well, after Joanne, I think I'm going to have to spend some time weaving.
Awesome. I'm now really looking forward to Saturday, August the 17th in Redfern. So thank you so much for joining us on NITV Radio to talk about the National Science Week and the Indigenous Science Experience Community Day in Redfern.
Thank you.
Thank you.